Good morning. Hi, everybody. Thank you very much for joining us again on the Saturday busy schedule. It was nice to see some of you from United States, like Los Angeles, Tommy Lee.
Thank you very much for joining us again on the
some people from Philippines. Saturday busy schedule.
Thank you very much.
It was nice to see some of you from
today is actually
will
be a very exciting webinar to deliver. It's a very important moment for us again.
And I think some of the things that we need to understand is why liver is so important and how can you prevent any kind of liver disease. And so today will be actually a very good webinar. I saw some people from also Facebook joining us. That was really nice. I think Pat was there. And so quite a few people actually. And we have people from Los Angeles, Vancouver, Hawaii, and various different places. Hi, 各位朋友, 我是Andrew Lau, Lowsutea President. 你好, 今天呢, 这个是一个很重要的, 题目, 因为很多人都不明白, 原来呢, 是, 如果糖尿病呢, 是可以影响你的肝的, 那原来肝呢, 是有什么, 有什么问题呢? 很多人都未必知道的, 但是变成来说呢, 我, 如果知道了之后呢, 就可以更加是理想多一点了, 那, 能够保护你的肝, 是, 为什么会保护你的肝, 是这么重要呢? 这个是一个我觉得是很重要的题目，变成来说大家了解就最低限度早些防御到你的东西是不会影响肝脏，因为肝坏了之后就很难好得回来。 OK，good. So I'm going to start off, you know, without further delay, I will start up my program. All right. So I have a lot of people who are some names that I don't recognize, so I thought that maybe perhaps I need to go through a little bit, helping fastly help people understand what is diabetes and why we're doing all this. So I will give about 7 minutes or so to able to do this. Okay, first of all, as you know, diabetic, you don't get well. But it's all this is a chronic disease, it's a lifetime disease. You basically, you really need all the might to help you to prevent get worse. You can control basically, and what we'll not talk about is how do you control is actually lower your blood sugar. And actually to do that you need several things. Diet control is very important, your exercise is very important, your weight control is important. And then so you in your diet you have to actually eliminate all the white food, soda and juice, and Lowsutea can be very very helpful. A lot of people drank Lowsutea now who actually saw the great benefit of Lowsutea not getting, you know, blood sugar increase, even though they're taking medication, it's okay. Everybody measure A1C, and we'll talk a little bit more of what is A1C is all about, so you can able to understand. Now, this is a very important slide that I think all of you need to continue to read and remember. The reason is this slide will give you all the understanding how diabetic form and why you have to drink Lowsutea way even before your pre-diabetic stage. Because the first stage of diabetes is a pre-diabetic is actually your cholesterol LDL goes up. And when the LDL goes up, you know what? It will damage the insulin that come out with the B cell, which support take the sugar into the cell, and the B cell are damaged, then it doesn't take sugar in the cell. So net result, more and more insulin come out, it doesn't work. But that the condition will come out will be really not good because your sugar goes up, your cholesterol goes up, two things goes up, it make the blood become very thick. And when the blood become thick, then it come to stage two, because it will start plugging in all the entire body with plaques. And then your blood pressure start going up. Now, this is where everybody should understand. When things are start plugging all over your body, maybe the first year nothing happens, second year nothing happens, third year nothing happens. But as time goes on, 5 to 10 years, that's where your problem going to start. And you plug and you're going to start getting problem with eyes. And later on, we'll give you a slide to show you all the complications. That's where you're going to start off the diabetic damaging the entire body. You can't go back to reverse and say, may I have a brush or something to clean it up, your vessel. It doesn't work. Once the blood is blocked, okay? So that is where you're going to start that journey. That's why you want to actually, if you could prevent yourself, you move to the third stage, which is your third stage, is your A1C start going up. And everybody measure that. What it means is your blood sugar start going up, and the doctor will measure your A1C. And what that is? A1C is actually a small protein. And basically, this protein will have amount of sugar that attach to the protein. And this sugar attached to the protein will be measured by percentage attachment, for example. And it will give you a 3 months average, okay? Like if my blood sugar is 5.7, that's mean I'm okay, I'm normal person. If the blood sugar beyond 5.7% to 6.4%, I become a pre-diabetic. If you continue to that pre-diabetic stage, keep moving, and in 3 years, many of these people will convert it to be a diabetic, then become stage four. And once you become diabetic, doctor will still give you some time. Hey, you know, you are now diabetic, you have a chance to reverse yourself, do it. But in 6 months, you don't reverse. The doctor, and especially your A1C will get down to 7, you know what? They will give you medication and you become a permanent diabetic patient forever and ever and will not reverse. Doctor will not say, okay, even to get better, they will not say, oh, you're not diabetic anymore. You're still going to be a diabetes. Okay. So this is one of the four stages. So remember this very, very well, because this is everybody basically need to have that in their mind. And so they know this is how the progression of four stage of diabetic. Now, 各位朋友，記住糖尿病咧係唔會好嘅，只係有控制嘅啫。 咁當你控制嘅時候咧，就一個好大問題啦。咁咧，然後咧就點控制啊？原來咧，你係要有 diet 啦，要有即係食材啦，weight control 啦，同埋要控制你嘅磅數啦。咁其實控制咧好簡單嘅，其實你就要唔食嗰啲叫碳水化合物，或者唔可以飲soda water啊，食白嘅麵包啊，所有白粉咧係可以全部咧減飲少得唔少。 咁應間我都會教你多啲要食啲乜嘢嘅。咁但係咧，依個咧係最重要嘅，就係一定要有運動啦。其實我哋有好多 program 教你點運動㗎啦，好方便嘅，即係行就得㗎啦。其實都第二樣嘢咧，就係你去減磅啦。點減磅亦都好簡單嘅東西嘅。咁亦都有啊，又有 exercise， 但係兩方面做埋咧，你個磅數一定會低嘅。咁所以變咗嚟講，依個咧我哋有好多 program 教你嘅。 咁其實好重要咧，就係依個 patient，依個 patient 係五四個 stage， 係點解你要變咗糖尿病患者咧？咁第一個 stage 咧，就係當你個膽固醇上升嘅時候咧，就會將嗰個胰島素嘅 B cell 損壞。當胰島素 B cell 損壞嘅時候咧，嗰啲胰島素咧就唔帶翻啲糖入去個細胞裏邊，咁你咪好多糖喺個血管裏邊同埋啲膽固醇一齊啦。 当呢两样捞埋一齐嘅时候咧，弊啦，因为嗰啲血咧就变咁好结啦。当啲血结嘅时候咧，就全身系咁塞。咁啊，第二个 stage 嚟喎，咁就系血压咧就开始上升。当你上升嘅时候咧，这个咧就问题认真系大，因为第一年塞冇乜问题，唔系好感觉。第二年塞落去咧，系10年后咧，咁你个糖尿病嘅情况咧就越整越坏。 好多嘅病嘅問題就會出現，依家我再解釋有咩問題。咁其實醫生咧就一定係 measure 依個叫做 HbA1c，HbA1c 咧就係一個叫做紅血球叫 hemoglobin 嘅protein 依個蛋白。咁咧就幾多個 percent 嘅糖咧黐住依個蛋白。咁如果你係5.7個 percent 咧，咁其實咧正常啦，撈個5.7就更加好嘅正常人啦。 但係多過5.7咧，你就變咗呢個前期患病，去到6.4都係叫做前期患病。當你乜嘢都唔做嘅時候咧，3年裏邊咧，好多朋友咧就轉咗去糖尿病噶啦。咁個醫生都會俾啲時間你咧，係咪可以減翻你落去一個前期患病咧？如果你做得到，你就唔係糖尿病。但係如果你咩都唔做，一去到7咧，醫生俾你食啦，或者上到6.5以上咧，佢都有藥俾你食啊，可能。咁但係當你有依樣嘢嘅時候咧， 你咧就變咗以後都係糖尿病者咯喎，所以變咗嚟講咧，你就千祈唔好去呢個 stage。 我哋希望咧，其實咧都希望能夠好早喺你有膽固醇上升嘅時候，糖開上升咧，已經係開始幫助你咧去建立你嘅每一日嘅習慣啦、食材啦。咁等你咧或者飲去糖茶啦，等你唔會直情都唔跌落去依個第三期啦。變咗你唔會係永遠唔會去前期患病，咁啊幾好啊！咁你身體更加健康啦，你個又唔會有好多其他嘅併發症出現啦。哇！依、這個係真係一流啦，因為就係講咧，我好多糖友咧，原來依家話俾我聽，其實佢話我如果我早啲飲你個去糖茶，我就唔會變咗咁啦。咁其實我哋依家個開始咧，就同嗰啲好多已經有膽固醇 LDL 上升嗰啲人咧。同埋糖開始上升的人咧，開始聯繫咧，咁開始諗去糖茶咧，哇，後果十分好喎、啊！佢其實都去唔到，即係佢 A1C 都唔會上嚟嘅，或者佢 A1C 係上嚟啲咁多，跌翻落去 5.7 以下，咁依個咧係會更加理想，唔係好似你話，哇，去咗糖尿病我先飲啦，咁你更加弊，千祈唔好做呢樣嘢 ，OK？ So it's so important a new message now, and I work with so many people. People have said.You know, if I have known myself, instead of actually getting me to really at the time when my not even A1C is 5.7, is actually lower, or even though I come up with a little bit 5.8, I start drinking a tea, and already I got, you know, a slight increase of cholesterol LDL, and I start drinking a tea. And you know what?They will bring the cholesterol back to normal level. Some of them is 120, 130. They drank it, it become 88. So, wow. Then the new message, you found that maybe this is even better. When your cholesterol goes up, your blood pressure goes up, you start drinking Lowsutea. Then they never get down to pre-diabetic. And rather than you get your pre-diabetic, your diabetes and drink, it is a little bit late. So we caught you early that you can actually prevent all the future.Potential complication, isn't that much better and much, you know, less problem? I think, yes, that is absolutely true. So let's try to do that early during Lowsutea, much earlier prevention. And basically, how Lowsutea work is twofold. One, there's actually one thing in Lowsutea has a thing called guava leaves. What it does is delay the absorption of sugar. And then the bitter melon,It helped the Lowsutea actually increase the insulin sensitivity. So it took the sugar into the cells, and then eventually excess sugar, they would dump it up on urine, the cholesterol come out urine, and also the salt dump out urine. And you know, with the salt went down, the blood pressure also come down, plus the detox. So a lot of people after drank Lowsutea, even though they are not pre-diabetic, they said, wow, you know, I felt cleaner, I feel good.A lot of young folks drink Lowsutea. You know what? They don't have any more pimple in the face. They feel much better. So these are the kind of things that you want to continue to do that to build your health. That will be so wonderful, right? 嗱，各位朋友，我哋飲去糖茶有咩幫助咧？第一，飲去糖茶原來有兩樣嘢嘅。第一個就係依個番石榴葉啦。番石榴做咩咧？佢就將啲糖delay 咗，減遲咗佢入血管，咁你少糖入血管啦。咁但係第二樣嘢就係有依個叫苦瓜，苦瓜咧係帶啲糖種入去依、這個increase 咗個細胞嘅 sensitivity， 然後increase 咗個胰島素嘅敏感度，咁佢就帶翻啲糖咧入去嗰個細胞度。咁同埋仲有咧，佢可能夠將嗰啲糖啦，同埋嘅excess 嘅糖啦，同埋個膽固醇啦，同埋啲鹽啦，就去掉喺個尿嗰度掉出嚟。當你三樣嘢掉出嚟嘅時候咧，佢有 detox 啦，降低糖啦，減低膽固醇啦，咁你個人咧就全部個身體咧就更加健康，繼續排毒，哇幾好啊！所以這個呢個咧。是帮助你降低血糖、胆固醇、这个血压同埋排毒。So, we had talked about earlier, well, if you don't do anything, what's going to happen? Well, the sad part is, if you don't do anything, you're going to have a risk of stroke, you'll lose your memory, And that's happened so many times. I don't know if you have auntie or uncle or grandmother keep asking the same question over and over again. And you say, oh my goodness, why you don't remember? But you really understand. They really cannot remember because the brain is all plugged up. The blood doesn't flow to the area. So they cannot have all the short memories. So they can't even know they ask you the same question. And they might be kind, but just that they can't remember. So I have that same experience with my mother-in-law. She's diabetic. She keeps asking me every 5 minutes, have you eaten yet? I said, you asked me 10 times, 15 times. But she can't remember. Okay. So that is a common thing that happens. Your eye become a glaucoma, cataract is so common. I have an engineer that is came in to tell me that eyes blur. But actually, you know what? Is had diabetic eye already. So we have to send him a doctor. They were able to save one of his eye. The pancreas malfunction no longer instant come out. But the more important, it affect your heart. That is really important because when you affect your heart, you know what? That can be really detrimental to potential heart attack, and nerve damage can be very, very big too, because what happened when the nerve damage, especially damage your vagus nerve, and you're gonna have all kind of guts problem, you have constipation problem, all kind of problem come along. So, and you cannot feel, okay? So you will not have you know, sexual function dysfunction because you cannot feel. So all that can be really, can be a serious issue for you. And your blood pressure will go up, remember? And then your blood vessel become hardened as a plugging all the blood. And then if you get injured and heal well, you know what? You have to cut out your foot. And 70% of the patient of diabetes patient have some form of diabetic nephropathy, you know, with the kidney damage. So again, that will be really sad because if you get down to 30% of your kidney function, you have to have dialysis. Wow, that will be tremendous affected on your lifestyle and your quality of life. Don't go on the route, okay? And then you have a pregnancy, you have gestation, diabetic, eventually you become a diabetic, while you have to watch. So all that complication can be prevented and you can do it. It's up to you to go for it. And I think you can, if you know the consequences, start now, you will be good. That's why a lot of people are why they listen to this webinar, because now they start understand, they know the seriousness of the disease and they start prevention. Now, 各位同友，其实咧，这个并发症咧系一个好容易出现嘅问题。嗱，当然第一、第二、第三年咧冇乜事发生啊，第五、第六、第七、八年就开始慢慢呢嘢出现啦。咁好多人咧就好快脆咧就开始有，即系譬如又系老啲人家咧，佢会有中风嘅风险啦。 个问题咧唔记得嘢，这个是好大问题，因为咧好多糖尿病或者70岁嘅朋友咧就会 end up 就问你嗰啲，问你成日都问你同样问，因为佢 short memory 嗰个短暂嘅记忆全部唔记得晒啦，已经塞咗个脑塞咗。咁变咗嚟讲咧，有呢样嘢成日问阿仔食咗饭未啊？问咗10几廿次，你好烦啊！其实唔系，因为佢真系唔记得嘅。 咁隻眼有青光眼啦，或者白外障啦，同埋個胰臟唔work啦，就冇咗胰島素出嚟啦。最大問題咧，百分之40至60%嘅病人咧有心臟病嘅原因就係因為佢血管係咁塞。OK， 咁啊，仲有神經系統損壞咧，哇！呢個仲弊，因為神經損壞咧，你會 affect 你成個肚嘅問題啦，任何地方嘅神經都會損壞，因為塞啊嘛。咁好多人咧就會 end up 就話便秘啦。 嗰個胃唔舒服啦，因為佢個vagus affect 咗個 vagus nerve 啦，咁好多嘢咧係會繼續嚟嘅。咁同埋仲有咧，你血壓會高啦。咁仲有咧，你血管啊硬化啦，因為佢塞咗好多血管啊嘛。咁你仲要斬埋只腳，如果你誒啲個傷口唔好嘅話，要割咗腳真係幾陰功啊。咁仲有咧就係70%依家嘅病人咧都有。 呢個腎病嘅問題，咁如果你係去到好差30%嘅percent function 咧，哇要洗腎嘅喎，即係呢個唔簡單嘅喎。咁同埋仲有咧，就好多人咧就有呢、這個性嘅問題，因為冇感覺嘛。咁如果你有懷孕有併發症咧，呢、這個亦都將來變咗糖尿病係成日都有好多啲咁嘅人嘅，所以要好好小心啊。 And our company have five programs helping you with diet, exercise, weight control, Dr. Wemmer, like you listen today, how to measure blood will give you all a whole system to help you to continue to better manage yourself. So that will be really wonderful. And what we want to do is we can help you from A1C, even if you have 10 plus, doesn't matter, we'll bring you down 5.7. If you are actually even not even to 5.7, even you're 6.4, we'll help you become, again, 5.7. Continue learning how to manage your diabetes. That's our goal. And you can see that, you know, this is what we'll do in here with exercise, weight control, Dr. Webber, and so forth. So, 我哋各位朋友咧，我哋而家最重要咧就係每我哋個五個 program 咧係幫助你咧係由食啦，係有運動啦，又有磅即係磅重嘅去減低你嘅磅啦，咁仲有聽我哋講書啦，同埋點 track 你嘅 blood 啦，希望你做一樣。 So today we will talk about liver. A lot of people say, why do you want to talk about liver? Why liver is so important? Well, first of all, you have to understand liver is a very important organ. And many of you, if you have liver disease, and usually there's no symptom because it is an organ that continue work on its own, but it's not working, but you cannot tell until you come a very advanced stage. In other words, your liver start really failing, then you can see problem coming in. Especially you are not even drinking alcohol, you have not in such a way that, you know, you have alcohol liver damage, you will continue to have type 2 diabetes, and then your liver become hardened, it causes cirrhosis of liver, and then, which is the most common death on diabetes, and usually about 4% diabetic death is related to this cirrhosis of liver. So this webinar will show you all the steps how to protect your liver so you become a more smarter person, if you will, as a diabetic, and then you don't have to get out to get to that stage. And that's what we're trying to do today. 各位朋友，今天很特別，因為很多人都不知道，原來肝病是一個很大問題的。為什麼肝病很多人，因為肝你看不到有什麼問題出現，多數都是一個 即係去到好差嘅時候，你先睇到個病。咁當你有依樣嘢嘅時候咧，就弊家伙。因為如果你係病好差嘅時候咧，你試去處理咧就好大問題，因為好難處理其實已經 reverse 得嘅呢啲嘢。咁仲有咧， 4.4% 嘅糖尿病患者咧有肝嘅嚴重問題，令到死亡咧係達到 4.4% 嘅，所以都幾高㗎，4.4低㗎。咁所以希望咧你唔會去到依個地方啦。 所以今日咧就俾 tips 能够帮助你咧，系保护你个肝，咁你变咗能够继续咧，可以身体健康，唔会有任何嘅问题。OK，now one of the interesting thing is if you have not drink alcohol, it will not damage your kidney, liver, isn't it? But on the hand, if you really do not well control yourself in your diabetes, because you have diabetic mellitus already, and I'm obese, and I have also tremendous amount of lipid all over the liver, and become, you know, a fatty liver issue, and with that will carry you become a cirrhosis of the liver. You know, your liver will harden, and eventually then you might even have several things will come in, your liver start damaging, and on top of that, you might have also forming a liver cancer, okay? So this is the kind of typical progressions of your liver problem. Two major things you have to really watch is one, obesity. In other words, you are really fat or big, and you have tremendous amount of not controlling your diet. You have eat all kind of fats in your system. So your liver really have a fatty liver problem. So this is the kind of thing you added together that's moved you to the cirrhosis of the liver. And eventually there's also potential cancer of liver. Now, cancer of liver is another total different story. You know what I mean? That's a stage, right? So you really want to stop yourself become cirrhosis of the liver, because that is the liver become hardened and it's not going to function well. You want to even stop over there. You don't want to get there, okay? You want to prevent yourself from becoming cirrhosis. That's what we're trying to give you all the tips, okay? 嗱，各位朋友，因為咧，如果你一個係 type 2 diabetes 嘅人咧，你會係好多時咧，你唔飲酒，但係你 liver 點解會壞咧？就好多時咧，就因為我哋依家第一糖尿病啦，咁已經係好多 issue 喺個影響個肝嘅問題喎。但係依啲人咧，多數係點啊？多數肥胖嘅，係好 overweight， 咁即係第一 BMI 過30啦。咁仲有一樣好大問題咧，依啲人咧多數係有個叫 fatty liver， 即係好多 lipid， 好多肥脂肪喺個 liver 度嘅。咁兩樣加埋咧，咪啦，咁就會變咗一個肝硬化嘅問題出現。當你有肝硬化問題出現咧，咁啊另外一個即係層面會出現咧，就係咩嘅咧？就依啲人咧繼續咁落去咩都唔做嘅時候咧，佢可能咧仲有一個咧就係、是肝癌嘅出現啦。OK， 咁依啲我哋希望各位唔好搞到肝硬化先去處理啦，因為如果肝硬化係好難搞嘅，即係已經係去到嗰個 stage 咧，翻唔到幾多轉頭嘅。所以希望你各位知道咧，就係 prevent 到你唔好去肝硬化，因為再肝硬化之後咧就有 cancer 啊啲咁出嚟咧，咁就真係好麻煩啦。OK， 咁啊盡量咧。是能夠令到你的肝不硬化，怎樣去保護你的所以你的 liver 啦 ，OK？ 嗱，記住 ，so the stages of liver damage is first you have a healthy liver you're doing okay， but then you start getting you know your liver become you know with all sort of diabetic coming in and you start doingyou know, not quite cirrhosis liver yet, but you are really getting a lot of fat to the liver and so forth and so forth. Now, but not quite to cirrhosis. All that you can actually can reverse. In other words, if you can control your blood sugar, control your fat intake, then you can do better to able to prevent yourbasically your you know your liver damage okay you don't want to get yourself all the way to liver cirrhosis okay that will be no good for you okay so before you get to the liver cirrhosis you can have actually reversible your liver damage okay嗱，各位同學記住，當我哋有依個 liver damage 咧嘅時候，最重要了解到係咩咧？就係、是、你最重要了解到嘅時候咧，你個 liver 如果係糖尿高咗上去，你好多 fat， 咁但係未到依、這個肝硬化，咁你係有機會咧係 reverse 到你嘅肝嘅問題嘅。咁最好咧，你真係盡量啦。如果你係可以去到喺依個 stage 嘅時候咧，你唔係搞到個肝變硬化咧，你依個就真係可能夠去翻個 healthy 肝，因為肝係好好嘅。因為有咗 healthy 肝咧，就冇好多其他問題出現。千祈唔好去到依個 liver cirrhosis 即係肝硬化裏面咧，你就唔好意思啦。依個咧就真係咧係轉變翻轉頭嘅，所以記住。在这方面我们现在尽量在这方面是帮助你不要搞到自己是肝不会去到硬化的情况。So what our tips basically today to help you to focus is to what is the tip to help you to prevent your liver become cirrhosis. Prevention of liver cirrhosis is our goal today for you. Okay? Now, how that done?Remember, the first thing that most likely these people will have very much called obesity. In other words, they are overweight, they eat a lot of high cholesterol item, fatty product. So really, at the end of the day, that's really the first stage. You need to stop to getting yourself this overweight and fatty diet. Because when you have that, that is continue to damage your liver, right?So to maintain a healthy weight is number one tip to prevent liver damage. So remember, when you're obese, you actually also make the diabetic become harder to manage. It will also start contribute factor that will get fatty liver disease, and which you'll be accessibility fat to your liver, which is now because of that, you increase the chances of cirrhosis of the liver and then potential even your liver cancer later on, okay? So the important thing is if you only lose 5% of your weight or even 10% of weight, you will actually already significantly improve your diabetes. Remember, if you get 10%, you already dropped 1 point of A1C. Wow, that's wonderful. And that result, you get able to decrease tremendous amount of diabetic risk already, okay? So really depends on how you gonna like exercise, a diet, that you can able to work together and your weight. If you can do all that, for sure, you can help yourself prevent the liver damage. And that's the key message here. Number one, maintain healthy weight. 各位朋友，其实好简单嘅，真系。因为如果你系已经控制咗你磅数，第一，你肥胖可以减低肥胖。因为当你系能够减低你肥胖嘅时候咧，你亦都控制到咩啊？你个糖尿病嘅问题。 因为当你唔系咁多糖，你都唔系食咁多脂肪，你减低嘅肥胖，你个 fatty liver 即系你个肥肝啊，咁已经系减低咗啦，咁就唔会有好多肥嘅东西喺你个肝个 build up，咁你已经系降低咗你个肝硬化嘅问题啦，同埋 eventually 亦都降低咗你个 cancer 即系呢个肝癌嘅风险咯。 咁第二樣嘢咧，當你係減咗10% of 你自己嘅磅數咧，你係能夠降低1% 嘅 A1C， 或者如果5% 你點5% A1C 咧，哇！咁亦都幫助你係減低你好多糖尿病嘅風險喎。第三，如果你個 weight 係繼續係降低嘅話，當然啦，你要做 exercise 啊，做 diet 啊，即係食飯啊，咁同埋你食物唔好肥嘅東西咧。 咁其實呢啲咧，全部咧幫助你 overall 一個好健康嘅生活啊！依個係好 natural 喎，係咪？咁係容易做嘅。咁但係你記住第一個 point 就係個磅數要管理啦。So the first tip we will teach you about is maintain a healthy weight. That is the number one, prevent your liver damage. Okay? So we talk about diet, right? So what it mean diet? So the liver diet is very simple. You have to have better diet to help your liver become more healthy. It's the same thing what we do in diabetes. You have to have fruit, vegetable, high fiber plant food to eat. You want to reduce high food beverages with high sugar like soda, cokes. You want to decrease the salt intake. You don't want to do refined carbohydrate, saturated fat, low calorie diet, and avoid what? Alcohol, okay? And then drink Lowsutea, 8 cups a day. And then you can pre and post meal each time. And also with that, you also need to lower your body weight through exercise and so forth. But the diet, if you can able just use a diet control, low calorie, you know what? You're lower calorie, you definitely can lose weight. I'll give you some example. One of my customer come in, he said, Andrew, I have a problem. I have now 200 something pounds, it's 210 pounds, I believe. And he said, I couldn't lower my weight. Well, I said, what have you been eating? Well, I eat the same old thing. So I said, gee, you know, when I start looking at that, what he ate, it really can be an issue because he hardly touch a lot of vegetable, he ate a lot of meat, red meat that is, and basically a lot of fat. He like char siu, you know, the Chinese barbecue meat. He eat a lot of Chinese whole chicken, you know, and all of fat in it. And every day he ate pretty much the same thing. He loved that kind of food, but no vegetable. So I said, look, you know, you got to really cut down that. So I suggested a lot of vegetable, half a plate of vegetable, Now start introduce what? Fish. And he said, I don't know, I eat fish. So I start getting him to eat salmon, cod, and all the good stuff. So he just changed diet in a sense of, vegetable. And instead of cutting a lot of meat, I just put down on dieting as like fish, like salmon and cod. And the rice, I told him to cut down the rice because, you know, rice is not going to help you a lot. So he started eating basically beans and also brown rice. And you know what? His weight after, now also I did suggest some exercise, but his exercise is very moderate, I think. He hardly walked basically, but he actually now ended up to walk half an hour in the shopping mall with his wife. And with that, after 3 months only, he lost about 5 pounds already, 5 pounds. And he thought that, wow, amazing. Before I never get it. But with this, he started encouraging himself with the dieting, little exercise. And you know what? His weight started coming down. Plus he started drinking Lowsutea. So his blood sugar also coming down. So all that come down. So it's not really that hard, you know, basically changing some of the diet and also the calories, because you have to really go down the calories. You can manage it if you got 1500 calories and 200 or 150 gram of carbs. I'm sure with that you can lower your weight tremendously. Okay, so keep that in mind, 1500 calories and then 150 gram of carbs, you will do that real well. Okay, just try that. It doesn't take a lot of effort, but when you try that, the calorie go down, you will start seeing the effect of your weight start going down and your fat also go down. And my friend become a lot more, the comment from them is that, you know, Andrew, I now feel like lighter. I like more energetic, walking with the wife, and even 5 pounds, they felt very, very good. So now he is so encouraged, it continues, okay? The key is continue. Now, then you have exercise regularly, okay? We'll talk about the second point now. The first part is weight. Second part is your diet. Now you have to regular exercise. The exercise is 150-minute exercise per week. And then you have to have at least 30 minutes of moderate exercise, like walking, bike riding, doesn't matter. Anything you want to do. And you can have doing a bike riding or going to Stepmaster, that's okay. But the 30 minute become an important exercise. And so my friend, what he did is actually all he does is go around walking shopping mall. And that's all he does. And net result, he was able to achieve his 5 pounds within 3 months. Wow, that's really good, man. And he was really felt that he was good and wonderful. Okay. 各位同友，记住咧，我哋头先讲咗咧，好简单嘅，就系第一你个磅数要减磅，要减磅。咁点减磅咧？就一定要做，如果exercise 啦，diet啦。咁其实我都讲咗咧，如果diet咧，好重要咧就系食大概即系多啲 fiber 啦，一半系菜啦，食多鱼啦，唔好食肉啦。同埋食啲低卡路里嘅东西啦，同埋咧饮去糖茶啦。咁我朋友咧，其实咧有个朋友咧，就佢只系做咗3个月嘅时间去减佢磅嘅啫。咁佢3个月磅系点减啊？原来好简单喎，佢介绍好中意食肉啦，食好多饭啊嗰啲东西啦。咁我叫佢减咗啦，佢就净系食菜。 然后就食鱼，鱼有两种鱼佢食嘅啫，其实佢食个三文鱼啦，或者食个 cod 即系石斑嗰啲白鱼白嘅鱼啦。咁其他咧佢就依家食红米啊 brown rice 啊。咁变咗嚟讲咧，佢就可能够将所有嘅东西咧就减咗之后咧，咁仲有咧佢个卡路里每日系少过大概1500 1500嘅卡路里，再加150 gram 嘅碳水化合物食物，咁同埋咧，佢每日咧都行30分鐘喺個 shopping mall 同佢太太行散步。 整完之後佢減三個月後面減五磅，同埋佢個身體健康咗好多。咁繼續努力，呢個咧，我覺得係一定做到嘅。OK。So the other one now we'll talk about going down to weight, going down to diet. Now we're going to exercise. Now the fourth tip is lower your lipid level. How do you do that? Okay, that is important because you know why? Your cholesterol, your triglyceride, if you're not controlled, then you can really, especially you do all kinds of saturated fat that you eat,And also sugar, all that will go into your triglyceride because all the additional fat that you accumulate, it goes in triglyceride, it goes up. And when it goes up, oh my goodness, your LDL mostly goes up, your HDL mostly goes down. So with all that, you got to eliminate all those sort of saturated fat. One of the good things that my friend also told me,He used to love to eat hamburgers, you know, hamburger, fatty hamburger. He loved that stuff. I said, you got to cut that off, my friend. You know, the red meat is really not so good for you. So he started cutting off the hamburger instead of using fish, like the white fish or salmon fish, and adding on his salad. Now, it did take some cooking, take some doing, because you know why? Not every people from Hong Kong, Chinese, like, you know, actually like fish per se. Matter of fact, it was a little bit against the eating salmon fish. But I said, you know what? Just pan fry without oil. Or if oil, just put some olive oil. And after he did that, you know what?He started getting used to it. He said, wow, I didn't realize fish tastes that good. and then he started getting some of those. And we asked him to add spice, like garlic and things like that, instead of eating a lot of salt. With that, he really able to change his diet from not very healthy food like hamburger, steak. He really able to cut down all these red meat and change to fish and salad and stuff like that. He loves it.And now suddenly he's drinking Lowsutea, 8 cups a day, pre and post each meal with 250 ml of Lowsutea. And he said, you know, really now I actually drank the tea first and then eat. Actually, he started eating less because the tea filled his stomach. And that result, he don't feel hungry anymore. And so with that, he will also continue to lower his body.Blood lipid because you no longer eat those red meat fat good stuff, right? One of the good things he also do is I suggest to him is that on snack, try to eat, you know, the celeries and chew on the celeries. And so that result also, he is able to lower his snack intake like cookies, cupcakes and stuff like that. That's what he used to do.So all that lowers your blood lipid level tremendously, and it's really a marked improvement. But importantly is you really have the diet, exercise, and also continue to work with your doctors. You know, your medication is okay the same. You tell them that that's what you're doing. And usually the doctor are pretty much, you know, whatever you're doing good, they will let you continue to do that, okay? So do check with them though. But drinking Lowsutea is important at the same time.Lower your blood lipid levels. So that's really important. Now, 各位朋友记住，因为呢好多人呢知道原来你的 cholesterol 高呢吃好多呢啲咁大高脂肪的食物呢是对认真有效有害的。OK? 我朋友好喜欢吃 hamburger, 好喜欢吃 steak, 的红肉啊 ,steak, 啊猪牛排猪排全部喜欢的。咁啊，最弊咧，佢食咗呢啲咁嘢咧，佢個 cholesterol 亦都上升啦。你知 cholesterol 上升咗有咩問題啊 ？damage 咗 B cells 啦，當 damage B cells 咪帶唔到糖落去血管裏邊啦，咁你就會老肥胖咯，有脂肪肝又會嚟咯。咁佢但係佢減低咗呢個食 hamburger 紅肉嗰啲東西咧，其實我依家最係食魚咧，佢都要一段時間習慣嘅，因為佢話哇，其實我好少食魚喎。咁佢依家食咗係咩啊？係食 三文魚啦，再食嗰啲叫cod 啦。咁佢依家食嗰啲石斑魚啊嗰啲，原來佢都要時間去適應嘅，因為佢如果煮嗰啲東西咧，佢未食慣嘅時候咧，真係好，佢話我唔好少食魚嘅。咁但係當佢食咗之後咧，佢話好食喎。咁同埋佢依家唔食咁多紅肉嘅時候咧，佢亦都降低糖嘅吸收啦。咁其實亦都啲肥脂肪吸收啦。咁佢降低咗佢血裏面嗰啲肥嘅高啊。咁依家就好重要嘅，變咗佢個 triglyceride 三脂油金牛脂亦都降低咗啦。咁仲有一樣咧，佢飲好多血糖茶依家。咁佢 definite 咧，依個亦都幫助佢降低咗佢嘅cholesterol 啦，咁亦都降低佢血糖啦，咁幾樣好埋曬咧，佢就話：哇，我覺得舒服咗人 ，OK。咁當然啦，你就要係繼續同醫生溝通啦，你食咩好啊？嗰啲依個好重要啦，嚇，因為唔可以就即係唔同溝通，自己做咗，醫生唔知嘅。要話俾你聽，咁多數醫生咧都，如果你係做啲嘢 work 嘅話咧，佢都係俾你繼續做嘅。So besides what we talk about so far now, we have also got to lower your blood pressure. I don't know, many of you go to see a doctor, they always measure your blood pressure if you have diabetes, and they say, hey, you can have all over 130. And the good old days, I thought, wow, hey, you know, wouldn't it be me is I can have 140, 150. The new rule is not. You got to go down to below 130, okay? And so net result now,you should be about 120, and your systolic pressure is 120 and lower. That's your target. And your diastolic supposed to be 80 and lower, okay? So don't mix up, there's no confusion. Is now the new rule is you got to be 120 lower, not 150. You have to be 80 and lower your diastolic, okay?So keep that in mind, and you really have to lower your blood pressure. When you lower your blood pressure, you know what? You'll be much healthier, have less chances of heart attack, and all the problems that will come along, and plus stroke and so forth. Diabetes really have to do that, because a lot of time is your nerve has been damaged, your vessel has been damaged, your blood pressure could be potentially go up. Remember one of the stage?So in order to do that, you have to lower your blood pressure. Now, a lot of people say, how do I lower my blood pressure? Well, first of all, you got to cut down your salt intake of your food. Secondly, you have the healthy diet, and you have to exercise. And exercise will help you lower your blood pressure. Because when you exercise, you relax your blood vessels start relaxing. And also when you exercise, you get rid of all the...potentially, you do a plaque, they will all soften up, your vessel becomes softer, and that result, you know what, your blood pressure will go down. And that will be wonderful, okay? Now, in addition to that, you have to quit your smoking. You don't smoke because that also increases your blood pressure. You got to get good sleep, and you have to reduce stress. And then you have to continue to measure blood pressure in the morning and at night after you go home, sit down, relax.And then you guys measure your blood pressure and see before you go to sleep, what is your blood pressure? You document it, write it down, write on your phone. And then you can show the doctor and say, hey, my blood pressure at home is about 125 or lower or 120. Get your target to be 120. If you exercise, I can guarantee your blood pressure will go down. Very important. That's why the exercise is one of the important things to get your blood pressure to improve. Okay. So,And certainly, your diet got to be eliminate much of the salt because your food itself has salt. So eat more garlic, spice, but cut down the salt. Then you cut down the salt, you are much better off your blood pressure because you lower your blood pressure, you are better off preventing a stroke or heart attack or other serious issue. Okay? 嗱，各位朋友，好重要咧。你要降低你嘅血壓啦，咁有啲人話點解降低啲啦？我一三幾喎，一四幾唔係咁嘅咩？梗係唔係啦，因為血壓咧就一定要係喺咩啊？120底下，呢個就新 rule 嚟嘅，即係新嘅target 120上壓係120以下，下壓咧係80以下，咁你就繼續咧身體健康啦。所以呢個好重要咧，就係你點爭取依樣嘢咧？咁第一。 你食物就冇咁多鹽啦。第二要係咩？運動啊！當你運動嘅時候咧，你將你血管咧係已軟化咗佢啦，咁令到你血壓就會降低嘅。咁同埋仲有咧，你要係點啊？冇食煙啦，仲要瞓覺瞓得好啦，冇減低你壓力啦，工作壓力啦，同埋每一日都要 measure blood pressure， 係朝頭早起身嘅時候咩情況，然後放工翻嚟臨瞓之前。measure 嘅血壓係點樣？咁你要靜啲先嚟 measure 喎，你唔好話哇，我跑完先 measure 咧，咁啊唔準嘅。Okay， so don't measure your blood pressure after you just finish running because that is not going to give you a good indicator. Also, always rest after 20 minutes. Then you measure your blood pressure in a quiet environment. Then you know how your blood pressure going. Rather than you after exercise measure blood pressure, wow, my friend, it's not going to work because that will be high. Okay.I can guarantee you. So remember, keep make sure you measure your blood pressure, you know, below 120 on the systolic scale, and measure blood pressure diastolic is under 80. Okay, so this is sort of the new standard now for diabetes. So make sure that you are continue to do that. Now, even you have 130, but not over 130. So keep that in mind.Now, a lot of people don't realize, actually, drinking Lowsutea becomes very important because when you drink Lowsutea, it actually helps you several things. First of all, you lower your blood sugar level because definitely if you drink Lowsutea, if you continue to drink, you can see your blood sugar level coming down. And a lot of people actually, if they don't drink, you know what? The blood sugar going up. One of the good examples is one of our clients, Faye. She forgot her Lowsutea, your blood sugar will go back up.Okay, as simple as that. And this is not only the person, every single people also tell me the same thing. Well, I didn't drink my Lowsutea, my blood sugar went up. How come? Because Lowsutea have that secret function, help you delay the sugar absorption of vessels and also increase the sensitivity, the guava leaf, to take the sugar into the cells. And on top of that, excess sugar will dump it up andurine and your cholesterol dump it off and your salt dump it off, your blood pressure come down. So it definitely help you lower blood sugar. It also help you lower what? Your bad cholesterol, LDL, it will go down. And with that, they also, because the salt go down, your blood pressure will go down and it really support your whole cardiovascular health. So you have, because your, all the blood pressure go down, cholesterol go down, sugar go down, your heart health is better.And also a detox because you make a lot of shishi. I remember everybody said, hey, you know, I drink Lowsutea, a lot of shishi. Well, that's good for you because you lower your blood, detox you all the time. And you detox the body naturally. Because Lowsutea is not a drug. It's just only a supplement, a diet supplement. But it has its function, help you do all that stuff. Lower blood sugar, lower LDL, lower cholesterol, lower your blood pressure, and also detox.And that is wonderful, okay? It's give you healthy. 其實飲血糖茶有咩作用咧？第一，血糖就幫助你咧降低血糖，呢個好重要啦，已經大家都知嘅，一定知嘅。如果你唔飲，個血糖會走咗上去嘅。第二樣降低咩啊？膽固醇啊，壞嘅膽固醇，呢個係好嘢嚟嘅，因為壞嘅膽咧咁樣降低咗你心臟病啊其他問題啦。第三，降低咗血壓，同埋咧。仲有幫你排毒，呢啲嘢全部咧係幫助你更加身體健康，同埋你心臟病啊，其他咧都全部係可以降低到嘅。咁你話幾好啊 ？So when you also when you visit a doctor, you have so also when you visit a doctor.You also need to check, besides your blood sugar, your kidney, one of the things you also need to check is your liver. Does it have any liver disease? So you really, if you basically check, usually there's a test, blood test called liver enzyme test. So if you can do that, that usually a very good way to understand where you're at.And but if because the problem is liver disease doesn't show any signs and symptoms, there are usually no signs and symptoms. by the time the signs and symptoms show up, you know what? And you really have a serious problem already. For example, you're going to appear with jaundiced eyes, the skin becomes yellowish color, you have abdominal pain, you swell, your leg, ankle will start swelling, you have itchy skin, you have dark color urine, your stool become kind of pale color, and basically it could be even not brownish color at least. And you have blood in stool. You are very tired all the time. You feel nauseated. You feel throwing up. You have no appetite. And you have easy to bruise yourself. You know, when you hit yourself, you start bruising, okay? And start bleeding. So all that are considered start seeing more serious liver problem. So really at the end of the day, when you go see a doctor, make sure you check, ask the doctor, hey, how's my liver? Now, if they suspected you have liver problem, they usually also do one more thing, ultrasound examination, see your liver become bigger or they have cirrhosis of the liver, they usually check that. But a lab test usually is called liver enzyme test. We'll be able to do that. So I hope none of you guys will end up with that kind of these sign symptom as jaundice, pain, swell pain. So all those, I hope is not there. So you will not get into serious issue, because when you get down to that, you already start getting to a stage of cirrhosis of the liver. That's all these going to come in. So hope that you don't get into that stage, okay? Now, 各位朋友，如果你去见医生嘅时候咧，当然啦，你系糖尿病病者啦，咁好多时你第一一定check你血糖啦，第二check你嘅身体嘅嗰个kidney啦，即系你个肾啦有冇问题啦，咁佢有多数做一个叫做kidney嘅 function test 啦，咁啊第三咧就系要睇下你个 liver enzyme test 啊，即系你个 liver 系咪有问题，咁呢个系个血。 即系做 blood test 嘅程序嚟嘅，咁如果你真系有问题咧，医生会做个 ultrasound 睇下你个 liver 咪大咗啊，或者呢个硬化，咁呢个 ultrasound 就出嚟。但系当你有其他问题已经出现嘅话咧，好似眼开始黄啦、黄疸眼啦，啲面色变咗橙黄色啦，咁同埋咧又有肚痛啦。 同埋你个脚眼开肿咗啦，啲身体亦都好痕啦，同埋咧你尿道咧系全部系好黑咖啡黄色啊 orange color dark orange 嘅，系即系深橙色嘅，咁同埋咧你大便咧唔系黄色黑咖啡色喎，就系好似灰灰地嘅，呢啲嘢系全部有问题出现咗嘢噶啦，咁你同埋咧仲有血液喺个。 即系血喺个 stool 度啦，即系你血喺嗰个大粪便里边啦。咁仲有一个好常见嘅人咧，就系佢好攰。呢个人一定系如果有肾病有肝病嘅人咧，系好攰嘅，同埋会作闷作呕啦，同埋冇晒胃口啦。咁同埋咧，仲有咧就一个好简单咧，就撞到嘢咧，佢就即刻流血。咁嗰度咧就会一个变咗全部好似肿咗啊，同埋一笪。 血喺度淤咗嘅喺个身体度嘅，咁当你有呢啲咧，你就真系快去见医生，即系话你个肝咧已经去到一个系差好差嘅 stage 嚟嘅，就唔系一个好嘅 stage 啊。So make sure that when you again take a picture of this, by the way, if you really see those signs and symptoms, that means you have a pretty bad starting approaching a not a good stage of your liver issue, and you should quickly see a doctor to control your liver disease damage, okay? So in summary, as you know, when you have liver disease, usually is a issue that you might not see the problem until the late stage. But on the hand, for type 2 diabetic, it is a common complication, and majority of people don't even know until it gets worse. And 4.4% people who have diabetic has related this liver disease. And they can die because of that, okay? So you gotta be careful, make sure you do not get yourself, you know, get very bad, you know, into that stage. Now, in order for you to really do good is one, you have to maintain your weight, okay? Your weight has to be doing good. Second, you have to have a good diet plan so you can actually make sure that you have 1500 calories and then another 150 carbs, gram of carbs to take. So when you do 1500 calories and 150 gram of carbs, I'm very sure if you're a little more exercise, your weight will go down. And if your weight go down just 5 to 10%, it will help you on your A1C, it will help your liver, don't get all the fat in there, that'll be wonderful. So you'll cut down your fat, more food with fibers, instead of red meat, you eat more fish, and instead of eat rice, eat beans, and also brown rice, more fiber type of stuff will help you to maintain a better diet. And you have to do your exercise. As I mentioned, 150 minutes per day, per week, and at least 30 minutes of exercise per day. And then you have lower your blood lipid. Your blood lipid, basically the way how you do it is cut down the fat intake, not going to McDonald's all the time, cut down your fat. And then you have to reduce your high blood pressure by have better good dieting, exercise, lower stress, then that result, your blood pressure will go down. If you exercise, definitely if you exercise, for sure, your blood pressure will go down because it relaxes your vessels and it will become less, your muscle will be hard, your blood vessels will be hardened. So that result, you will lower your blood pressure. And today, target blood pressure is 120 over 80, not 140. Not 130 above. If you do 130, there's margin already. You have to go back down to 120, okay? And you have to be under 80, so 70 is okay. So that is your new target. Certainly, you have to drink Lowsutea per day. 8 cup, pre and post, each meal, pre and post. And that result, that will lower your blood sugar, cholesterol, and also your blood pressure and detox. So that's why drinking Lowsutea is so good. You hit 4 items, all the things you need, lower blood sugar, lower cholesterol, lower your blood pressure, and at the end, detox. Wow, isn't that great? And suddenly, if you see sign and symptom of liver disease, you better go ask your doctor, hey, what happened, man? I got pain here, I got yellow, jaundice face, all that issue, you got to get help as soon as you can. Okay, I hope that will give you a very good insight how to protect your better liver. Now, 各位朋友, 今天呢,講得很簡單,但很容易做的東西, 每個人都要呢,是好保護個肝的, 因為呢,如果你不保護肝呢, 很多在糖尿病者, 有4.4%的糖尿病者, 就會死了, 變成很慘啊, 那你一定要怎樣能夠保護肝呢? 咁不過好簡單就係你係能夠要即係你個磅數降低啦， 咁你個diet方面呢， 就食啲嘢就1500個calorie啦， 或者係150g嘅碳水化合物啦， 要做exercise啦， 每日做30分鐘， 一個禮拜做150分鐘啦， 咁就降低咗， 你會降低你自己嘅磅數， 同埋亦都降低將你， 因為你exercise啦， 咁你血管又會硬化啦， 還有就是要降低你的血壓， 那你exercise一定會降低血壓的， 那要降低鹽的食品， 還有就是要喝你的去糖茶， 喝8杯就會身體更加好， 因為你去糖茶有4樣東西降低的， 第一,幫助你降低血糖， 降低血膽固醇， 降低你的血壓， 再是降低排毒， 哇,真是開心了。 還有,如果你真的有很多 不同的現狀出現，好像肝硬化的，快快去看醫生，看怎能夠控制到這件事。 So I hope today the lecture will be good, give you a good idea how to control your liver damage. and make you sure a healthy liver, because liver is definitely a very important organ. And I hope that you will be always keep yourself healthy. And you know, really everything seems to be related. It's very simple to do. Only thing is up to you to go get it. And if you can do it, you know what? You'll be so healthy, live happier, and become a long life. Enjoy your grandchildren and lots of energy. Okay, I wonder any other question from your group. Maybe I could help to answer. It'll be really cool if you can do that. If you have any question, please write to me also. This is my email address here. You can write to me. I could help to answer your question. And we'll go from there if you need any additional help. So any other question from the group? I hope I can give you this insight. And if you any question I could answer, that would be wonderful. Okay. Well, if there's no question, I appreciate, thank you very, very much for joining our webinar on the actual how to prevent liver damage. And I know you guys are busy, and it was so good that you helped you around to listen to our webinar. And I hope that you continue to be healthy and continue to drink Lowsutea, helping you to lower your blood sugar, cholesterol, blood pressure, and detox. Okay, thank you very much. Goodbye. Bye-bye.